questions. What is linear superposition of two simple harmonic motions means the two particles having displacements x1 and x2, the resultant displacement of the two particles is nothing but sum of the individual displacements. Sum of the individual displacements of the particle is called what? A linear superposition principle. Linear superposition principle. Okay, now the resultant displacement is nothing but sum of the displacements of the individual particles executing simple harmonic motion. Okay, simple harmonic motion. Understood?
Yes, sir.
So I will write.
Sir,
objects will be in the simple harmonic motion as well.
The resultant, write down. The resultant displacement. The resultant displacement of the particles executing simple harmonic motion is the sum of the individual displacements. Individual displacements okay. For example, if a particle executing simple harmonic motion, it will having displacement sum x1 and the second particle having displacement what on a x2, then the resultant displacement of this combination of the system is nothing but x equals to what, Nana? X1 plus x2. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Right? So this is what the superposition principle. Superposition principle. The resultant displacement of the particles executing simple harmonic motion is the sum of the individual displacement. Resultant displacement denoted by small x equals to x1 plus x2. Okay? X1 plus x2. Is it fine?
Yes, sir.
Right. I will tell you. Okay. So, first I will explain the equation, then you will understand. Okay. Pictorically, I will explain. Okay. So, here, what is x1? For example, take the simple harmonic motion of first particle, that is a cos omega t.
Plus
the second phi. I'm taking is what? Zero. Initial phase is what? Zero. Next, I'm taking another particle displacement to
b cos omega t.
Omega t plus pi. Okay, now b cos omega t plus pi. So here, what are a comma b nana here? What is this a comma b?
Constant.
No, these are our amplitudes. Amplitudes, okay. A comma b. Y equals a sin omega t, where a is the amplitude. I told you so many times.
Yes, sir.
So these are the amplitudes, sir, of the two motions. Amplitudes of the two motions. Amplitudes. Okay. What is omega?
Sir, omega
Angular velocity, sir.
Angular velocity or angular frequency, sir, omega.
Frequency.
What is this phase? Pi, nana. What is pi?
Sir, initial position.
Phase difference between them. Okay, now phase difference between them. Okay. Now tell me, what is the resultant displacement on x? X equals to what is x1? X1 is nothing but a cos trigonometric formula. That is, I will give you some trigonometric formula. Cos of a plus b. Cos of a plus b equals to, we can write
cos a minus sin a.
Okay, now this is the trigonometric relation you have to remember. Okay, next to cos of a minus b.
Yes, sir.
What is cos of a minus b?
Cos a plus sin b.
Next to, I will give one more, that is sine of a plus b. Sine of a plus b equals to
cos a minus cos b plus cos b.
Okay, next to sine of a minus b equals to
sine a cos b minus cos a sin b.
So these are very, very important formulae you have to remember. Everyone, MPC and BIPC students. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Right. See here, in the above expression, we have x equals to a cos omega t plus b. It is of the form what? Cos of a plus b. Cos of a plus b. What is cos of a plus b? Cos a cos b minus sin a sin b. Here a is nothing but omega t and b is nothing but pi. So I will write cos omega t
cos pi
minus sin omega t
sin pi.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Right. See here. X equals to A cos omega t plus B cos omega t cos pi minus B sin omega t sin pi. Okay. So in this what we have to take common on cos omega t, cos omega t? We have
cos
to take common.
Cos omega t take common.
Cos omega
remaining will be a plus b.
B
cos pi. Cos pi.
Minus
sin
omega t. B sin pi. Okay, na? This is equation one.
Yes, sir.
This is equation one. So here, I'm assuming few terms, that is I'm assuming that a plus b cos pi, which is equals to, I will take as r cos theta, capital R cos theta, and I will put b sin pi, which is equals to r sin theta. If I substitute like this, what happens? Let us see where R is the resultant amplitude. So the equation will become x equals to
resultant amplitudes.
Cos omega t a plus b cos pi means we can write
R cos theta.
R cos theta. Okay. Minus sin omega t. What is b sin pi? R sin theta.
R sin theta.
In this, we can take R common, take outside, and the remaining will be cos omega t cos theta minus sin omega t sin theta. So this is of the form
sin theta.
Which type of equation it is? Cos A cos B minus sin A sin B.
Yes, sir.
Cos A cos B minus sin A sin B.
Cos
cos of a plus b cos of a plus b cos of omega t plus theta
theta
okay therefore the resultant displacement x equals to r cos omega t plus theta r cos omega t plus theta okay
Yes, sir.
So the resultant yes, displacement is also a simple harmonic motion. Simple harmonic motion where r is one and resultant amplitude. Resultant amplitude. Okay.
Resultant amplitude.
So here I am going to give an expression for resultant amplitude. Resultant amplitude of the system. Okay, see here. So this is, for example, this is equation 2, this is equation 2, and this is equation 3, this is equation 4. So from 2 and 3, can we find out what is capital R? Is it possible?
Yes, sir.
So how to find R, Anna, in this? So what I'm doing, Anna, I'm doing equation 2 square and which is nothing but what, Anna? If you do the square, you will get a plus b cos pi
whole
square equals to
r cos theta whole
square. Okay. And this is nothing but what, Anna? This is nothing but A square cos square pi plus 2ab cos pi equals to
r square cos square theta.
Next I am doing what, Anna? Equation 3 whole square. What is equation 3? B square sin square pi equals to what, Anna?
R square sin square theta.
If you add equation 5 and 6, Nana, what we will get, see, if you add these two, you will get
A square plus B square plus cos square pi plus 2AB cos pi.
Plus b square
cos pi
sin square pi, which is equals to r square cos square theta plus r square
cos square, square theta.
Okay. Any doubts up to now?
Yes, sir.
A square, take b square common, you will get cos square theta plus sin square theta.
Yes, sir. Cos square theta plus sin square theta is equal to 1, sir.
Equals to 1. Okay, now.
R square so, into 1. R square,
yes, sir.
You will get here A square plus B square. This whole term will become 1. No, 1. Okay.
Plus yes, sir.
AB cos pi equals to R square.
R square.
That implies you can write R square as A square plus B square plus 2AB cos pi.
2AB cos pi.
Therefore, resultant amplitude R equals to
under root of a square plus b cos pi.
Okay. Okay.
Yes.
You have to remember this final yes, answer. That is resultant amplitude capital R equals to under root of a square plus b square plus 2ab cos pi.
Resultant amplitude.
Hi.
Okay. Okay, Rana.
Yes, yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Okay, sir.
Next, we are going to find out one resultant phase. The resultant phase that is angle, the phase angle. Phase angle is one theta. Okay. We have to find out what is theta. See here, from equation 2 and 3, if you want to find out theta, what we can do? Equation 3 by 2 or 2 by 3, whatever you want. Okay, na? Okay. If we do equation 3 by 2, equation 3 by equation 2, tell me what is equation 3?
What is equation 3?
B sin pi equals to R sin theta. Equation 2 is A plus B cos pi equals to R cos theta.
A plus B cos pi equals to R
cos theta. Any cancellation? R or get cancelled?
R
remaining. B sin pi equals to
A plus B cos pi equals to sin theta by cos theta.
Initially the tan theta equals to
do cross
b sin pi by
theta by sin pi b by sin plus
b
cos pi
cos pi cos pi cos pi. Okay, from this the phase angle theta is given by tan inverse of sin pi by a plus b cos pi. Okay. Okay, is it fine?
Yes, sir.
The linear superposition principle. Okay.
Wow.